Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss about one numerical related to concepts of free body diagram. So here is the numerical which is related to concepts of free body diagram. The numerical is a smooth sphere of radius 20 cm and weight 4 newton is supported in contact with a smooth vertical wall by a string whose length equals to radius of sphere. Find out the inclination and tension in string and reaction at wall. So this is the numerical. Here we are considering a sphere or a smooth sphere. See, if it is given, there is a smooth sphere or smooth surface, so it will be frictionless. So here we won't consider any friction force. So this particular circle is representing the cross-sectional area of the sphere, and the radius of the sphere is represented by the R. And this O is representing the circle of the sphere. So here, the radius of the sphere is given. It is 20 centimeter and weight 4 newton. So we will write these given terms here. So, the radius of the sphere is represented as 20 centimeter and weight of the sphere is 4 newton, and we will denote this weight by W. Now, let's read the next term. So, this particular sphere, this is the sphere, is supported in contact with a smooth vertical wall. So, this particular sphere is supported by this smooth vertical wall, and this is a fixed surface and it is represented by AB. There are two points we are considering on a smooth wall, that is AB, and see, there is a term given, smooth vertical wall. So here on this particular vertical wall we won't consider any friction force. So let's read the next point. This particular smooth vertical wall and this sphere is connected by a string. So this particular inclined line is representing the string, and the length of the string is given here. It is equals to the radius of the sphere. So this particular string is having a length. So this particular length is equals to radius of sphere. So this is our condition, which is related to radius of sphere and length of the string. So this is our condition which is related to length of the string and radius of sphere. Now let's read the next point. Find out the inclination and tension in the string and reactions at the wall. See, this particular sphere is connected by point B with this vertical wall, and it is connected with the string with point A. Here, the string is connected at point A, and this is the upper point. This particular point we are considering as the upper point where the string is connected with the sphere. So here we have to find out the inclination of the string. So this particular inclination of the string is represented by theta, and this inclination we are considering with the horizontal line OB. So here we are considering triangle OAB, and the angle between line OA and OB is represented as theta. So this is our diagram, and here we have to find out the tension in the string, because the sphere is having some weight and the weight is always act vertically downward. So when we are considering weight vertically downward, so because of this we will consider tension in the string because of this weight W. So here we have to find out the tension as well as the reactions at the wall. See, this particular sphere is connected at point B. So at this connected point, we will consider a reaction. So let's draw the free body diagram for this particular condition and find out the solution. So this is our free body diagram. In this particular free body diagram, we will consider three types of forces. So the first force is and the second force is tension in the string which act vertically, tension in the string which act at angle theta with the horizontal surface, and the third force is reaction at the supported point. So here we are considering three forces. Weight of the sphere, which is act vertically downward. Here you can see in this diagram, the tension in the string, which act at angle theta, and R is the reaction at the support. So here we have to find out this value of T and this value of R. So first of all, we will find out the value of theta. So this is our actual diagram, and here we are considering the triangle OAB, and we have the value of OB, that is representing the radius of circle or radius of sphere. Here there is a circle, so we will consider the radius of circle, and the length of the string is represented by OB, and the condition is given here, the length of the string is equals to radius of the sphere. So up to this particular point, we will consider the radius of the sphere, and from this point to point O, there is a length of the string. So this total length OA will be equals to R plus R. So this length OA will be 2R. So here we have the value of OA will be 2R, and OB is R. Now we will find out the value of theta. So from triangle OAB, we will find out the value of theta. So as per this particular triangle OAB, the cos theta will be, so here the cos theta will be OB divided by OA. So here the OB is R and the OA is 2R. So here we will write cos theta will be R divided by 2R. So here the cos theta will be R divided by 2R, that is equals to 1 by 2. So as per this, the value of theta will be 60. So here the value of theta we have 60 degree. Now we will find out the unknown value, that is tension and the reaction in the particular sphere and string. So we will apply the Lamy's theorem. Lamy's theorem is the simplest method to find out the unknown forces like supports, tension or weight and internal and external forces. So let's apply the Lamy's theorem. So as per the Lamy's theorem, to draw the diagram, we will use this particular diagram only. So for the Lamy's theorem, the diagram is, so here we have three forces, and the angle between these forces we will find out. So here the first force is W, and with the horizontal, this force W is making angle 90. and this T and R is making angle theta. So we have the value of theta, that is 60 degree. So this particular angle will be 60 degree. So if we want to find out the angle of T from this particular direction, see, this is our positive x direction, this is our negative x direction, this is our positive y direction, and this is our negative y direction. So from positive x direction, if we want to find out the angle which is made by the T, so it will be what? It will be 180 minus theta. So it will be 120 degree only. Now we have the value of theta, so the angle between T and R will be the 60 degree only. And if we want to find out the total angle of this T and W, so it will be 90 into theta, and this R we will consider in this particular direction only. So this diagram will be like this. So this is our actual diagram for the Lamy's theorem. Here the angle between R and W is 90, the angle between T and R is 120, and the angle between T and W is 150. Now let's apply the Lamy's theorem. So here the angle in front of T is 90, the angle in front of W is 120, and in front of R is 150. So as per the Lamy's theorem, so this is our equation for the Lamy's theorem. It will be T by sine 90 equals to W by sine 120, and it is equals to R by sine 150. And if we again solve this equation, so this equation will be so with the help of this Lamy's theorem, we can find out the value of T by this equation and the value of R with this equation. So this particular equation will have the value. So here W into sine 90 is 1 and sine 120 is 0.866. So it will be 4 into 1 divided by 0.866. Now we will find out the final value, that is, so here the final value of T is 4.61 Newton. Now we will find out the R with this particular equation. It is W sine 150 divided by sine 120. So the equation will be So the value of R as per this equation is 2.31 Newton. So here we have the final answer, that is, tension in the string will be 4.61 Newton and the reaction at the support will be 2.31 Newton. So this is one method to solve this particular numerical. Now we can solve this particular numerical with resolution of forces also, with equilibrium condition. So let's start the next method. This is also a very simple method. So for resolution of forces method, we will use this particular diagram only, and we will resolve all the forces in x direction and all the forces in y direction with equilibrium condition. So if we resolve all the forces in x direction, so the forces will be, see here, R is acting in x direction. So there will be force in x direction, that will be R, and the another force is T, and the T is acting at an angle theta with a horizontal direction. So there will be components of T we will use. So X component will be T cos theta and y component will be t sine theta. So if we resolve all the forces in x direction, so it will be r minus t cos theta, because r is acting in positive direction and this t is acting in negative x direction. So it will be r equals to or r minus t sine r minus t cos theta equals to 0, because we are considering equilibrium condition. So here we will write all the forces in x direction. If we resolve forces in y direction, so the forces will be, the force W is acting in minus y direction, so it will be minus W, and the force which is acting in plus y direction, that will be t sine theta. So as per this, our equation will be then we will solve the value of t with the help of this particular equation. So we have this term for t and we have the value of W. So it will be, so as per this, the value of W will be 4.61 Newton. Now we have the value of t, so we can find out the value of r. So as per the equation, we can find out the value of r. So the value of r will be 2.31 Newton. So this is another method to solve this particular numerical. So this is a basic numerical which is related to free body diagram. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.